How can we model the spreading of a contagious disease? A straightforward approach may be to model individual persons as either infectious or susceptible. If one infectious and one susceptible person meet, there is a certain chance that the susceptible person becomes infectious too. And then the first infectious person, as well as the newly infected person, further spread the disease. This seems to cry out loud for a spatial model in which we take care of the location of these persons. That would be complex. Luckily, there is another way. This is a much simpler way of thinking about such diseases, the SIR model. We do not look at the spatial distribution at all. We simply say that our population is made up of susceptible, infectious, and recovered persons, and we only look at the total number of these persons. Susceptible persons can get infected and then become infectious. The rate of that process is controlled by the number of infectious people. The more infectious people there are, the larger the probability is that a susceptible person meets an infectious person. Hopefully, people are going to recover from that disease, so there's a process that takes us from infectious to recovered. And in the standard version of that model, we assume that the recovered persons are immune and cannot be infected again. So they form a third compartment. This is a much simpler way of dealing with that problem. We forget about the spatial distribution altogether and simply construct a mechanical model, if you will, in which the population consists of three compartments: susceptible persons, infectious persons, recovered persons. Depending on the number of infectious persons, susceptible persons become infected and hence infectious, and after a while, infectious persons recover. And we assume that recovered persons are immune against the disease and cannot be affected again. This is the SIR model, susceptible, infectious, recovered.